Welcome to an introduction to polynomials. The goal of this video is to identify polynomials and know the different vocabulary terms used when discussing polynomials. So let's start off with some vocabulary. A term can be a number, a variable, a product of numbers and or variables, or a quotient of numbers and or variables. Here are some examples of some terms. 5x, -3a² b³, 1/5, -8/x², m over n, 7x⁻³. These are all terms because they satisfy these conditions. A monomial is a real number and or the product of variables with non-negative exponents. So some of these terms are monomials and some of them aren't. 5x, -3a² b³, and 1/5 are the only terms that are also monomials. These three terms are not monomials because these two involve quotients of variables, and this one has a negative exponent. A polynomial is a monomial or a sum of monomials. Remember that subtraction can be rewritten as addition, so it may show up as a subtraction of monomials. So for example, 5x+3 is a polynomial. -x³ + 5y² - 8 is also a polynomial. Now polynomials do have further classification based upon the number of terms in the expression. So for example, if we have monomials, mono means one, so we have one term. All of these are monomials. Binomials consist of two monomials connected with addition or subtraction. Here are some examples of binomials. If the polynomial has three terms, it's called a trinomial. Here are two examples of trinomials. And once a polynomial gets past three terms, we usually just call it a polynomial. The word poly means many. Let's go ahead and consider this polynomial. The first thing we should be able to do is list the terms of the polynomial. And the only thing we have to be careful about is dealing with the subtraction. So the first term would be 4x² y³. The second term, remember the original definition of a polynomial was the sum of monomials. So this is the same as plus a -12x³. So the term is -12x³. I just think that you take the sign with it. If it's a minus sign, treat it as a negative. The third term would be 24xy. Fourth term would be x. And the fifth term again would be a -15. Next, we want to talk about degree. The degree of a term is the number of variable factors in that term. You can also say the degree of a term is the sum of the exponents on the variables. So the degree of this first term, because there's two factors of x here and three factors of y, the degree of this term would be 5. You can see an easy way to do that is just add the powers on the variables. This term has degree 3. This term has one factor of x and one factor of y. Therefore, the term has degree 2. This would be x to the first, so it's a degree 1 term. This does not have any factors of a variable. Therefore, the degree is 0. Or you could also think of, if you had to include a variable, it would have to be something like x to the 0 power, because that would be equal to 1, which would not change the term. The leading term of a polynomial is the term of the highest degree. So this term in the polynomial has degree 5, therefore we call it the leading term. Notice the terms are in order from highest degree to lowest degree, and this is called descending order. Considering the same polynomial, the degree of a polynomial is the same as the degree of the leading term. Remember, this is the leading term. It had degree 5, therefore the degree of the entire polynomial is degree 5. Next, the coefficient of a term is the constant factor or the number part of the term. So the coefficient of this leading term would be 4. The coefficient of the second term would be -12. The coefficient would be 24 for this term. This coefficient would be 1. And this coefficient would be -15. The leading coefficient is the coefficient of the leading term. So in this case, the leading coefficient is 4. Okay, let's see if you can put all these pieces together. We're given a polynomial. We want to first list the terms. 2a cubed b squared is our first term. 7a squared b squared is our second term. Our third term is negative 0.5ab squared. The fourth term is 25b, and the fifth term is negative 21. Remember, the coefficients are the constant factors of the term, or the number part. So this coefficient is 2, this coefficient is 7, this coefficient is negative 0.5, 25, and negative 21. Next, the degree of each term is the number of variable factors, or the sum of the exponents on the variables. So this term has degree 5, this term has degree 4, this term has degree 3, 2 factors of b and 1 factor of a. This has 1 factor of b. This has 0 variable factors, so it's degree 0. The leading term in this case, because it is in descending order, would be the first term. That's not always the case, so you want to make sure you check to choose the term with the highest degree. The leading coefficient then, of course, is 2, and the degree of the polynomial is the same as the degree of the leading term, which is 5. Hopefully all this new vocabulary makes sense, and you found this video helpful. Thank you, and have a good day.